parties. but I just want to thank everybody for coming out. This is, see, I don't want to cry. The theatrics of it all. But everybody who's here, especially, I'm just so happy to see a lot of old friends and new. This is the second part of the Life Remix Speaker Series. Can you pass me my book? Is it over there? Because I am going to do a shameless plug for my book. But it's on sale at Amazon. But I want to share, just like really, really quickly, the whole concept of Life Remixed. For those who have not seen it, I will pass it around. I have a couple of copies. You know, a lot of us here are hip-hop people, and the cool thing is that we've all reached a certain part of our life where the things that we did before, we have to change. You know, I guess at some point we have to mature. Many of us are married, have children, have mortgages, car payments. And so how do we function and how do we bridge our lives from how it was in the 80s and the 90s to where we are in 2013, rapidly moving into 2014? You know, we have to factor in globalization, technology, the economy. And I will share this with you. Just part of the whole concept of Life Remixed is about rethinking everything that we did. How do we take that hustle that we all had and make it grow and manifest it into something that's sustainable throughout the rest of our lives? So in the spirit of that, many of you who do know me know that I was a publicist for many, many years, and I got sick and tired of being in PR. It's a very thankless job. When things go well, you're praised, and when things go wrong, everybody blames the publicist. And so in that space, I started working with a lot of people. I don't even need to get into the list because it's not even necessary for this, but about booking them for speaking engagements. And this was actually probably started in 2002, 2003 when I was in Atlanta. And I just realized there's a huge market for keynote speakers. As many of you may or may not be aware, Hillary Clinton just left being the Secretary of State and left, and she's now giving paid speeches. Everyone is waiting with bated breath for her to give her first paid speaking engagement now that she's no longer the Secretary of State, and it's coming up. You know, we all know about our esteemed President Barack Obama and his excellent oratory skills. And so one of the things that I saw in the spirit of that is the disparity in people of color who are speaking professionally versus those who are not of color who are speaking professionally. And I really started my agency that was originally Impact Agency, now it's Cy Brown Global, in the spirit of giving our people, just kind of us, our message is just as important as their message. And so I spend all day kind of on the phone seeking opportunities for us to broaden the audience and allowing us to unmute ourselves and give us the opportunity to have our voices heard as well. Hillary Clinton is awesome, she's amazing, she's Secretary of State and all of these other things, but her message, in my opinion, is no more important than any of ours. It was no more important than Kangol's, it's definitely no more important than Keith's, but who's out there advocating and fighting for us? So in the spirit of Life Remixed and just being able to give my people or people that I know have an amazing story to tell a bigger stage, this whole speaker series was born. So many of you joined us almost a month ago now, and Kango was our esteemed speaker, which, you know, and I will say, you know, we had an awesome, awesome event. We were approached that night to secure a speaking opportunity for him that opportunity may not have existed had we not convened here. So before I go on, I want to share with all of you that we are in someone's private residence. This is actually someone's home. She has opened up her home to allow me to do this here and continue the series. So I would like to bring Gillian Bell up to the stage, who has food in her mouth, who's gonna kill me. And this is her house. Thank you, Gillian. My sister in curls. I'm probably gonna be a full of curls tonight. It's gonna sweat out, you know, in a minute, right? So thank you, Gillian's house.
Thank you so much for coming. Tonight. My name is Gillian Bell from the Urban Yoga Foundation, and we use yoga to unite the community. The original meaning for yoga is to yoke, to unite, to come together. And we also use yoga as the foundation of artistic, academic, and creative expression. The idea is that if your tool, your being, is not strong, supported, and healthy, you cannot do the work that you need to do. And we are here to help you promote health so that you can create. You can talk about what you want to do, you can share your thoughts, you can share your dreams, you can share your platform, and we come together upstairs, downstairs. We use the whole house to make everyone feel at home, safe, healthy, and creative. So thank you so much for joining us, and thank you so much, Sally.
Thank you for letting us come into your house. Thank you very much, Jordan. I really, really appreciate it. So without further ado, I'm going to bring up our speaker for this evening. I have to honestly say, Keith, I wasn't a fan, didn't even know you until a couple of hours, not too long ago. But the cool thing is when you and I met, we had the most intense conversations. Like, your story is bananas. And obviously, I, like so many others, saw FUBU as a brand, a clothing company, LL Cool J in the house. And as a consumer, you know, I bought it for my sons, that's all. But after the conversations that we had, I realized that there's so many layers underneath that. And I'm just really honored that you chose to work with me to help you in this next part of your life, speaking, sharing your story. I take that to heart. You know, you and I talk 6 o'clock. Thank you for letting him talk to me like 7 o'clock. I'm sending Keith text messages early in the morning. But to even allow me to invade your space and to take those calls as we kind of move your brand and your message forward. So I just want to say publicly, thank you for your trust for allowing me to do that. So without further ado, I would like us to all put your hands together and introduce Mr. Keith Perrin to the stage.